Hey guys, I just wanted to show you a quick way to have the computer draw your line of best fit and also figure out the slope of your line of best fit because I feel like that will be helpful maybe in some future math classes and science classes as you're analyzing your data. So you'll see we're in a Google Sheet here, and what we're going to do is type in whatever you want to go on your x-axis in the first column. So for us, that was the volume. And then what you want on your y-axis to go in the second column. So for us, that was mass. So we're gonna highlight both of those columns, and then we're gonna go up to the top where it says insert, and then we're gonna choose chart. When we do that, it kind of looks at your data and tries to decide what kind of graph it thinks would be best. And so over here on the right, it says chart type. So that is not the type of line we want. Instead, we're gonna change this type of graph to a scatter plot. So we're just gonna have these small dots here. And so this looks more like what it would look like if you were graphing this on paper. And then from there, we're going to go to this button here that says customize. And then I'm going to choose the option that says series. So we have some different options here, but what we're most interested in is the trend line. So trend line is another way of saying line of best fit. So as I choose that, it automatically draws our trend line for us. And then if we want to know what the slope of that line is, and for us that slope would mean its density, if I scroll down here to where it says label and I choose use equation, it will show the equation of our trend line or our line of best fit. And hopefully we either already know or maybe we'll be learning soon in our math class that the number in front of the x, that is the slope. So for this particular line, the slope is 6.03. So if this data that I randomly came up with was for an actual object, that object density would be 6.03, and in this case, grams per milliliter, since those are the units I used in my measurement. I can also choose this option that says show R squared. Your R squared value is showing you how close of a correlation you have between your independent and dependent variables. So if this was a perfectly straight line, our R squared value would be 1, exactly 1. Now we're pretty close here with 0.995, but depending on the lab that we're performing, having an R squared value of 1 shows us that, again, our independent and dependent variables had a nice correlation between the two. So hopefully this makes your life a little bit easier when you're dealing with the line of best fit and calculating the slope. Thanks.